This offseason, Manny Malhotra was one of the first free agents to sign, inking a contract with the Montreal Canadiens. That's a far cry from last year at that time, as he couldn't even get a tryout after an eye injury almost ended his career. That's almost. Christine Simpson has more.
Manny Malhotra's decision this summer to sign with the Montreal Canadiens was straightforward and uncomplicated. But his journey over the past 3 years has been anything but. In March of 2011, Malhotra was struck in the left eye by a puck.
He's been cut.
I remember a searing pain and just wanting to get off the ice.
The focus changed from, is he going to be all right, or is he going to be able to see again? Back in my mind, I never thought I'd play a day again.
It was such a stressful moment to realize, like, everything sort of stops in your life when something like that happens.
I didn't know if I'd be playing at all anymore, never mind the rest of the season. I was just scared of not being able to see again.
During his recovery, Malhotra sought advice from a former teammate who'd experienced a similar traumatic eye injury.
With Manny being able to send me a text or to talk to me, I think made it easier for him.
He was really good and kind of calmed me down and said, layman's term, this is what happens. This is what it's like. It's as if it happened.
I told Manny that you just got to prepare yourself and just be patient.
It meant the world to me just to have him in my corner.
After multiple surgeries, Malhotra still didn't have full vision in the eye. He met with the doctor who performed the surgeries to hear the news.
When he took the patch off, I was looking at him, he was standing ahead of me. So he looked at it, used all his instruments and everything, and then he gave me the how many, how many, how many. And I rattled them all off, and he's like, all right, it works. I can't really describe the feeling. Eternally grateful for basically being given that gift of sight again.
He was given the green light to come back. At the same time, the Canucks were in the midst of a stirring playoff run.
I kind of gave the tongue-in-cheek, so how long do you think, Doc? And with a serious face, he said, you know, I could see you come back and, you know, with proper protection, you know, 6-7 weeks or so, and that's kind of around finals time, you know, and that kind of gave me a real boost.
There's a huge media frenzy that when he got to the Cup that he was going to play. And I'm like, are you doing this? He's like, yeah.
Walking to game 2 of the Stanley Cup final.
Manny Malhotra coming in, going to take the draws. I couldn't believe it when he's coming back.
It was such an amazing moment in the arena. I took some video on my phone and it just blows my mind.
I remember that tunnel run out to the ice, and then as soon as hitting the ice, hearing my name being chanted, I get goosebumps just talking about it. It was definitely one of the most special things in my career.
After his dramatic comeback, Malhotra's eye required further treatment. He struggled through the following season.
Your sight obviously was good enough to play, but it still is not 20/20, is it?
I keep telling everybody, it's not 20/20. It's not what it was. I'm not going to be able to read you a menu in a dimly lit restaurant, you know, but at the same time, it's good enough to play.
Canucks management disagreed. 9 games into the 2013 lockout shortened season, GM Mike Gillis placed Malhotra on injured reserve for the rest of the year.
Well, for me, it was the hardest thing I've done in this job. We came to the conclusion that for his long-term health and his long-term safety, that this was the best thing we could do.
For him to try to stop a player from playing, and then obviously we all know the NHL, once a GM kind of gets down on guys, he can kind of ruin a player's career. And I think that was wrong at Gillis.
A lot of anger. Kind of what do I do now sense, and definitely a feeling of kind of being lost.
Speaking with both Mike and Manny, I know it was an incredibly hard talk and decision for Mike to do that.
Whether we agree with the decision and what you think of Mike, there's no doubt in my mind he was acting in what he thought was Manny's best interest. He thought that Manny was putting himself at risk.
Gillis's decision severely hindered Malhotra's ability to find work in the NHL.
That carried a lot of weight around the league, and it carried a lot of clout, and I think just by hearing those words swayed a lot of people in one direction.
You couldn't believe no one was getting a job. It's like, are you calling everyone who you're talking to? And I had to keep telling them, like, I'm talking to every team. There's just teams won't bite at it.
Malhotra was healthy and in shape, but he needed an opportunity.
Trained just as hard, if not harder, and I had in years past to prove that I'm ready, I'm going to play and I can play.
I don't think I've ever had more respect for him watching him than when I saw him go to the rink for weeks after they had started and just kept going. He just kept going.
Finally, after months of waiting for a contract, Malhotra received a call from then-Carolina GM Jim Rutherford, offering him a tryout with the Hurricanes minor league affiliate in Charlotte.
He hadn't played in the minors in over a decade or something, and I think to be so elated just for the chance to go play and just to be on ice, and he was okay with proving himself again. It was, you know, it was humbling, I have to say.
That was just the one opportunity I needed to prove myself.
After a brief stay in the AHL, Hurricanes management liked what it saw, and Malhotra was called up to the NHL.
We needed some leadership in our dressing room in Carolina, and we felt if he got through the first hurdle in Charlotte that we would check him out again with the doctors, and he'd be a good fit for our team.
In his third game with the Hurricanes, Malhotra let everyone in the NHL know that he was back.
This was his goal, and he accomplished it. And nobody can take that away from him.
Nobody can. And Neil, many surprised when Malhotra came back, but you were not.
Well, no, I drafted Manny Malhotra in 1998 from the Guelph Storm, and he was always a great kid. Like, when you met him, you met his parents. They have a great faith. They're a very closely knit family, and what I saw in that video was exactly what I remember about him as an 18-year-old. He's just a great kid. He works his tail off to be a hockey player, and he did back then. He went through lots of adversity in his career. He went from the New York Rangers to the Dallas Stars, put on waivers, picked up by Columbus. He jumped around after that. Just an amazing kid, an amazing work ethic.
And a good guy in the dressing room. And he's been a tremendous pickup for Canadians this year. As we've talked about before, he takes almost all of their defensive zone faceoffs, 66% success rate there. And that's allowed Thomas Pekanec to take on a much more of an offensive role. Most of his faceoffs now in the offensive zone. So it's really helped at both ends of the rink.